the enemy. It ain't nothing but the devil. That's what the resistor is. And so I looked up the definition of resistor. And it says, it's used to reduce current flow, to divide energy, and to terminate transmission lines. To reduce current flow, to divide energy, and to terminate transmission lines. I kept thinking about that. I said, so the enemy wants to reduce the flow or the speed of the blessing. He wants to separate you from your life source, that energy, and he wants to end your blessing. And when thinking about that definition, the scripture came to me that the thief came to what? Steal, to kill, and destroy. So what favor is? Favor is the Father assigning victory over the resistor. Because he came that we may have life and that we may have life abundantly. The resistor cannot terminate the transmission of the blessing that is headed your way. He cannot do that. All favor will step in every single time that the transmission wants to be interrupted. Favor just gets in between that thing, and it says what the devil meant for evil, God's going to turn it around for your good. That's why we can rejoice. That's why we can trust in this God that we serve. It's because favor just gets in between and won't let that transmission interrupt what's coming your way. Our posture is to trust and to rejoice in everything. Give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continue to be in my mouth. No matter what state I'm in, I've learned to be content. All the scriptures are full of what we should do. James 1:2 says, Amplified Version, consider nothing but joy. Brothers and sisters, when you fall into various trials, consider it nothing but joy. Now, in the natural, it may seem like, okay, that's not doable, but if it wasn't doable, he wouldn't have put it in his word. He said, consider it nothing but joy. Whenever you fall into various trials, then it goes on to say, be assured that the testing of your faith through experience produces endurance, leading to spiritual maturity and inner peace. And let endurance have its perfect result and do a thorough work so that you may be perfect and completely developed in your faith, lacking nothing. Look at the sequence, saints, of this. Count it all joy whenever you fall into a trial. Just count it joyful. You already know that it ain't gonna be good for you anyway. Count it all joy when you fall into a trial. It produces endurance, patience, spiritual maturity, inner peace, makes you perfect and completely developed, lacking nothing. What if every time you got into a trial, that's what you put the foremost on your mind? When I come out of this, I'm going to be spiritually mature, I'm going to have inner peace, I'm going to be perfect and complete, developed, lacking nothing. What if you went into every trial that way? What if we went just thinking, Lord, I bless you for this trial. I thank you for what you're taking me into, because I know what you're getting ready to pull out, and I know what you're getting ready to develop. What if you just approach every single tribulation and every single circumstance and every single situation and said, I count this joyful. I just count this joyful. I know you're working on me. I know you want me to make meat for the master's use. Tomorrow, I want you to get in a position where you say, Lord, I bless you. Oh, this is a trial. This is an opportunity for my Rejoice, beloved, because he has us covered. And if you look at the word compassion, it says it's surrounded and enclosed. He has us surrounded and enclosed in favor. And Sister Jam, I kept just trying to picture that in my mind. I'm like, you got me surrounded and enclosed. That means ain't nothing get in. I'm surrounded. I thought about a fork. It is surrounded. You have to remember, but it's surrounded and it's enclosed in a favor. Oh, so when I looked at that and reading the scripture, favor has a twofold responsibility. Favor is a defender and it's a covering. And to illustrate this, if you don't mind, I want to use a couple of football examples so to get you to understand this twofold responsibility of favor. You know, because if everybody know I'm a 49er fan and that game just Rams just made me mad, but anyway. I don't know if I was so mad that they gave up in the clutch or the fact that I had to listen to Jared Mouth because he's a Rams fan.
Jared Mouth.
Luckily, Chris, he didn't come home and say nothing, so I didn't have to put him out. You know, we have this ongoing battle with that, so I told him that's for me and my house, we are 49ers. We still got, now don't get me wrong, but I'm just saying as a football term, 49ers. But here it is, I want favor, is to look at favor as the defense part of it. And then looking at it, on the football team, on a team, there's a position called cornerback. And the cornerback responsibility is to defend against pass, offenses, and tackles. And he said there's a special thing of a quarterback, and only certain ones get this title, and it's called shutdown corners. And shutdown corners are cornerbacks who possess the ability to cover the receiver so effectively on either side of the football field. And I just saw that as favor being the cornerback or the shutdown corner. It says what that does is that anything that is wrong, that cornerback or that shutdown corner is so good, so skillful, and so agile that it don't matter that eventually the quarterback is tired of trying to get it to the receiver because the cornerback job is doing such a great job that he's like, okay, I can't even get in. And I just saw that with the devil. He be throwing so many passes, and that favor just blocking every single thing that he's throwing at you. Because that's what favor does. Yeah, like, right for a while, he just gets tired. He's like, okay, I can't even reach you. Ain't know what he told Joe? You got a covering around him. If you release that covering,
that's right.
Because that's what favor just got you covered. It's just so agile. It's like, I'm going to read this play before it even happens. So that's how favor is a defense. And it's so skilled, saints. It don't even matter what that devil is trying to throw at you, or the thief, the enemy, the receiver. It doesn't even matter. It can picture a fade that's getting ready to happen. It can picture sideline and out routes. And I know as women, we probably don't know all these positions. Men are like, yeah, I know what that one is. I know what the Hail Mary is. They know all of it. But if you watch football, that's what the quarterback kind of like, okay, how they lined up. I got to kind of predict what they're going to do. And that's what favor does. It just predicts what's getting ready to happen. And as a covering, Lord showed me that that is like a guard on the football field. And a guard is used as a protector. But also it takes the position of creating openings for the running back to go through. So if I can have Finest and Jared and Javon and Chris come up. Is Chris gonna be okay? The Steelers and the 49ers, because that's God's son's team, got to work together. OK? okay? And the Rams and the Raiders got to work together on this one.
Wow.
Okay, we're not doing no talking. Okay, so Jared is representing the faith. Finest and Javon is on the other side. He's saying, this, we are the resistor. The whole goal is not to let the